Hello everyone, what is up? Welcome back to Danganronpa. Now, if you guys remember, we had just finished the prologue and we had been introduced to Monokuma. Anywho, without further delay, let's get right into chapter 1. You can't get out unless you kill someone. My mind and my body were completely entwined by those words. Fear and anxiety seeped into me, spreading until they had taken complete control. I felt the room's intense atmosphere pressing down menacingly upon my shoulders. It was all I could do to bear the weight of it. Kill free or live hard. Everyday Life, Chapter 1. That ominous air was shattered by the blunt force of her words. So, what are you gonna do now? We're just gonna stand there, staring at each other? The harsh bite of her words was directed at everyone in the room. And like a cold shower, those words yanked us all back into reality.
Yes, of course. There are times when we must push forward, no matter how funny or uncomfortable a situation may be. How could I forget something so fundamental? I'm deeply ashamed. Would someone be so kind as to hit me? I cannot forgive myself. Hit me, I beg of you. If you got enough energy to make all that goddamn noise, how about you move your ass instead?
And what's the tip is our quest? Is our quest, master?
We're gonna look for a way out of here.
While we're at it, let's wait until he's driving that weird-ass teddy bear and beat the crap out of him. First, let me check our electronic. Hey, best we looked over the rules Monokuma mentioned before moving around too much. Yes. We wouldn't want our ignorant onions to invite another spectacle like the one we just witnessed. Then, let's do this.
Makoto Naegi. I powered up my electro ID, the first thing that appeared was my name. Looks like Monokuma was telling the truth about that. From the moment that displayed next, I pressed the button labeled School Rules. And then on the screen appeared a bullet point list of the regulations we were to follow. Students are to live out their lives together exclusively within the academy indefinitely. 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. is designated nighttime. Beware, certain areas are off limits during this time. Sleep is permitted in dorm rooms, so deliberate use of any other room will be treated as sleeping in class. You may investigate Kubigani Academy freely. No limitations have been placed on your actions. Violence against the headmaster, Monokuma, is forbidden, as is destruction of surveillance cameras. The villain who kills one of his companions will graduate, provided his crime is not betrayed. Additional rules may be appended to this lesson deemed necessary. Starting to feel like a little vertigo, I turned my head away from the screen. I glanced around himself and saw the same silent expressions on everyone's faces.
The fuck is this shit? Like I don't want myself to be pushed around by some dumbass rules!
Now why don't you just continue on your merry way and pretend the rules don't exist? I personally am rather curious to know what the penalty is for violating one. Were you to do that, Master Mondo Uwada would have no extra lives remaining.
When I was solo, that's what my big bro always used to get on my case. About how a man keeps his promises even in death.
So?
I still got promises I ain't done keeping. So there ain't a chance in hell I'm dying now.
I can't say I understand, but either way, can we take that to mean you'll be following the rules then?
yeah, I guess so.
Guys, I have a question. Rule number 6 here, what do you think it means?
The villain who kills one of his companions will graduate, for his crime is not betrayed. You mean the part that says, provided his crime is not betrayed by the TEO students? Yeah, I was wrong about that too. If you want to graduate, you just have to kill in such a way that nobody finds out it was you.
What? Why?
Don't concern yourself with the why. Just follow the rules you've been given, and that's all you need to know. People who need their hands held to accomplish anything has no right to ask questions.
Such pointed words.
You mean pointed?
Anyway, enough of this stupid murder stuff. We know the rules, so we can start looking around now.
Where exactly are we? Is there anywhere else? Do we have provisions and supplies? There's a mountain of questions in need of answering.
Hell yeah! Let's get the show on the road!
I'm going alone.
Huh? See what? Is something wrong with your head? Like, seriously, why would you do that?
Someone in this room is probably on a plot on the way out of here. You expect me to let any of you get anywhere near me?
Wait! Nobody here!
You can't enter of that. Now are you, just like how scared you are when Monokuma explained graduation. Or was that something else? I'm gonna do what I want to do.
Quit your bitching, you ain't going anywhere. Be gone, Plankton. Oh, what's that supposed to mean?
You are but one individual Plankton drifting through a vast ocean. Try as you might, you're not but the tiniest, most inconsequential existence.
Sounds like someone wants his teeth kicked in.
So stop it, guys, please. Fighting isn't gonna solve anything.
Why aren't you just a sweet talker? You think you're some kind of teacher? You trying to preach at me?
No, I just...
Then shut your trap!
Bam. He hit me on the floor. It's like a scene straight out of a cartoon. Without warning or foreshadowing, completely out of the blue, he hit me and I flew. It must have slipped my mind the kind of people I was dealing with. Super duper high schoolers. Around whom my brand of common sense has no weight, not a silver meaning. Of course, something ridiculous was going to happen. I guess it just slipped my mind. My consciousness slowly drifted away, and then vanished. When I woke up, I was...
What? Where am I?
I seem to be making a habit of waking up in unfamiliar rooms. Anyway, where exactly am I? You now have access to your electro ID, which contains a wide variety of information. You can open your electro ID by pressing the square button. From there, you can view the school rules or report cards, profiles of all the students. Some menus like map and ammunition are only accessible under certain circumstances. You can also save and load the game from the system menu. Additionally, you can press the select button for a quick access to the game's bat log. Everything anyone says is recorded in the backlog. Everything you should ever need to reread something. So, here we go. Review the dialogue and everything. We'll save just in case. And while we're at it, might as well look. View stuff. Let me see. I know they said I had a present somewhere around here. Ah, here it is. School insignia pin. Okay, so here's all the information on everyone. We got Makoto, Kiyotaka, Byakuya, Mondo, Leon, Hifume, Yasuhiro, Sayaka, Kyoko, Aoi, Toko, Sakura, Celestia, Junko, Chihiro. Yep, that's about everyone. We can check the schools and everything else later. But for now, I can suspect everything. This looks like the shower. Huh? It won't open. I guess it's locked. This is a liberal? Cleans on me, it seems. It's a notepad. This came into the room, didn't it? This is the room key? It's got my name on the keychain, so I guess that makes it mine. I'll be taking that. Just a regular trash can. No trap doors or hidden compartments here.
Ooh. Oh. Well, you know.
It looks like iron plates were rigged to the walls. Let's see. There's a bunch of shit I haven't accessed. There's a TV screen here. Ugh. A sheep here who sucks the wall. It says, an apprentice from your headmaster, Monokuma. The room locks have been equipped with an anti-picking mechanism. The keys are a bit of a pain to make, so please don't lose yours. Everyone comes with a shower, but be aware, water is shut off during the nighttime. Only the showers in the girls' room are equipped with locks. Lastly, I prepared a modest gift for each of you. A ladylike sewing kit for my female students, and a masculine toolkit for my male students. The sewing kits include a pressure point diagram. A single thrust is all it takes, ladies. For the men, I work on a solid swing to the top of the head. Don't think, feel, and have, and let's all have a killer time. I'll cover the paper and toss to the trash can. Man, Monokuma really wants death to happen. This looks like the door leading out of the room. It seems to be fixed with a lock. A lock, huh? Well, what else am I missing? It's a bed. Doesn't appear anything out of the ordinary here. Maybe I have to check my desk? It's not in the drawer. It's a toolkit. It's brand new. The plastic seal appears unbroken. Neither am I going to use it now, so I'll put it back. I think I got my bearings. I'm pretty sure this is. Sleeping permitted in dorm rooms. Deliberate use of any other room will be treated as sleeping in class. It's one of the bedrooms in the dormitory area. This one probably cured me after I lost consciousness. That's my first question. Now, what's everyone else doing? There's only one way to find out, by leaving the room. I'm pretty sure I have to memorize every single detail. I think I have a big brain. I stepped in my room to look for everyone else, and waiting for me on the other side of the door, a situation like you might see in an old manga. Oh, it's Sayaka. Maizono? Sorry, guys. Are you okay?
No, it's my...
Oh, they're speaking. Sayaka embarrassed smile rose to her face and she slowly brought herself to her feet. Are you sure you're alright, Maizono? You're not hurt, are you?
You're being melodramatic. All the bump like that is that's no big deal. I may not look like it, but I'm actually pretty tough. You still like dancing around I do on stage.
That's a relief.
Oh, no. More importantly, what about you, Naeki? Still hurt? Where I want to hit you?
Oh, yeah, right. I got knocked out in front of everyone. See, one knows how much of a loser I am.
Naeki?
I'm fine, it's nothing.
It's gonna hear. I was worried about you.
Thanks. By the way, what brings you here, Maizono?
I came to check on you. Check up on you.
Check up on me?
See if you're feeling better. I was wondering if you'd join me in the cafeteria.
The cafeteria?
After you got knocked out, I decided to split up and look around. We thought we'd cover more ground individually. And we thought we were gonna meet up later and share what we found.
So it's almost time for that? Well, in that case, of course I'll go.
Wonderful. I'll meet you there, then.
Well, let's check around the rooms. Here. Here's Naegi's room. Maizono's. Fukawa's. Fujisaki. Asahina's. Kagami's. Kawada. Hakagure, Yamada's. This building is pretty impressive. If I cannot buy a shrink chair to allow me to kill someone, I'd like to live in a place like this. And we got Celis, Inoshima's, Tsugami's, Iwata's, Ishimaru's, Kirigiri's. Okay, so that's the dorm rooms, and that's all of us there. And where is the... Ah, here it is. Maizono said we were all gonna meet up in the cafeteria. This is the cafeteria.
You gotta see that's well kept. There's no time for that. We are still trapped here, after all.
Yeah, you're right. As far as I can tell, nobody else has arrived yet. So I guess we'll wait.
You're right. We'll just have to wait.
Whoa, you heard that?
Of course. I'm an expert. I'm kidding. I just had a feeling, that's all.
Was that really just a feeling?
Pardon the interruption, but it's time for a tutorial. Today we're talking about the REACT system. I plan to initiate a conversation with Miss Sayaka Maizono, were you not? When you talk to her, you're going to see a couple of purple phases like this one. When these purple phases appear, press the charge button to enter React mode. Select the phrase using the D-pad and then press the X button to inquire for further information. Please use the React system, reacting to things your partner says. Please enjoy your new life in the economy. It seems you're a quick study. Wonderfully done. Skills using this technique will allow you to progress in your relationships. I mean, the story. Okay, so then let's talk to Maizono.
By the way, Maggie.
Yes?
While I'm picking up our introduction left off, this is what I've been doing.
Our introductions left off?
I'm interrupted back there. There's something I wanted to ask you.
Sayaka Maizono has a question for me. I wonder what it could be.
By the way, Maggie.
Yes? What is it?
Are you by any chance a sixer? Noriko 6 junior high class 2?
Yeah, I was.
I knew it! I went to Noriko 6 too. I was in class 4 though, did you know?
How couldn't I? Even in middle school, she was so super duper, super duper famous. I can't possibly have not known her. But the thing that surprised me most is that she remembers me. We weren't in the same class and we never really talked to each other.
Is something the matter?
No, I was surprised. I didn't think you remembered me.
Of course I remembered you. We went to the same middle school, didn't we?
But a ton of people went to our middle school. And there's nothing all that noteworthy about me. Most average of the average, ordinary to a cliche degree, a fan of most anything ranked number 1.
Oh yeah? What are you talking about? You're so silly, Maggie.
What? How am I silly?
She lets out a cheerful, girlish laugh. I'm in love with Maizono. Her smile was mysterious and comforting. I couldn't think of any way to describe it other than amazing.
It's nice to find out there's someone here that I know. Someone just saw me and they cheered me right up. You're wonderful.
I'm nothing special compared to all you super duper high schoolers.
But you're the one that cheered me up, gave me courage, not anyone else.
Thanks, when you put it like that.
Yes. Alright, as thanks for sharing your strengths, I'll be your super duper high school sidekick.
Sidekick?
I'll be your sidekick, Maggie. So I'll do whatever I can to help. Let's make it out of here together.
Hearing Maizono say that
makes it feel like I can do anything. Which is all fine and well, but what's taking everyone so long?
Actually, first of all, what time is it? There should be a clock running somewhere. Let's see. Let's see, the current time is...
What? It's 7 at night?
You went for a really long time, didn't you?
Jeez, I'm kidding. Finding windows, I don't even have a sense of time. If I'm stuck like this forever, I'll probably go mad.
Everyone tries to take your time, huh? They should be here soon, I hope.
I knew soon she said the door to the cafeteria swung open.
If it isn't Naegi and Maizono, so the two of you were at the head of the pack, huh? And here I thought it was first. What a disgrace. It just goes to show that I'm not trying hard enough. But I won't give in! Next time my victory is assured, justice always prevails!
Well, it's not that big of a deal.
And not long after that, one after another, the remaining students gathered in the cafeteria. After just a few minutes, everyone had finally arrived.
Excellent. Looks like everyone's arrived. I move to commence an assembly, post-haste, such that we can, together, make known unto all the fruits of our investigation, and escape from this place as quickly as possible.
second.
What is it?
What was her name? That silver haired chick. Right. Kyoko Kirigiri.
What about her?
She's not here.
What?
I spun like around the cafeteria. And she said Kirigiri was nowhere to be found.
Where do you think she is? Has anyone seen her?
Everyone just shook their heads.
Nobody's seen her anywhere?
The reason she's not here is because...
Eating, stabbing, pounding, cutting, burning, crushing, strangling, slaughtering, hexing. The method doesn't matter. What's really important is that you can't get out unless you kill someone. So whatever it takes, that's getting the best results from the worst method.
No way, it couldn't be. I'm worrying too much, that's all.
Kirigiri, you went slant late on your first day. Being late is one thing, but that's to inform me in advance to shrink your duty as a latecomer.
You know what maybe saying is, like, ridiculous, don't you?
Regardless, time's of the essence. What's done is done. I hereby declare the first regular Kibigane Academy Informational Assembly open!
Hey, Maggie, to start, since everyone has to go out and look around, we should see what they have to say.
Right, sounds good.
Kind of.
What's up?
Just then, Fat Guys really was your sidekick? I'm not a very dependable sidekick, but I'll do my best for you.
I don't think I have more dependable sidekick than you, Maizono. Okay, we'll start from left to right like usual. We'll start with, Byakuya over here. Oh, you damn cursor work. What, I can't question him first? Oh, I guess we'll start with Maizono then.
He must not explain things for you. That's when we go to investigate the school. Sagami and Ishimaru went off by themselves. Oh yeah, and Kirigiri did too.
I was looking for clues as to who might be behind all this. I found nothing, that is all.
That's all?
Had I found anything, I would have informed you.
Of course. Understood.
Unless I guess we'll talk to Maizono to do this.
Sagami and Ishimaru went off by themselves. Oh yeah, she did too.
Ishimaru.
I investigated the dormitory area. And there I made a discovery of the century. There's room for each and every one of us.
I already knew that. That was the first thing I checked out. There's a name for how she eats these doors, seeing whose room it is.
They're even so kind as to provide us with keys and name tags. It means I thought the room I was just in was mine.
Our rooms look like they're totally soundproof too. Maybe Fuchisaki tested it out. It screams through our lungs. You can hear anything in the room next door. And there comes a wonderfully clean shower. Is there a lock on the shower door? The place that's like the girls are.
Sure, my shower was locked when I checked it out. Strange. I should look at that again. Give me a second, you guys. I'll be right back. Sorry, guys. Let's continue.
I'd rather have a room than not. This way, we need not worry about fending for ourselves.
So you have to share? It's too unlikely, Mr. Honor Student.
I finished my report. Who's next?
Okay, come on, Sayaka. Keep going. Oh boy. Give me a moment real quick. Sorry about that. I had to temporarily stop because the game is freezing. But I'm gonna try and merge that video with this one. Let's keep going. You're joking with me, right? Okay, now the game's starting to glitch out on me. Anyway. Kawada, Hagagure, Inoshima, and Fujisaki feed together.
We checked out the iron plates in the windows, in the halls, and classrooms. We figured one of them might, like, come loose or something, but...
Game over, man. Game over. None of the damn things budged even an inch.
There's no way out. We really are trapped in here. This sucks. Like, what do you even do?
Hey, chill. You're freaking me out. Asahime, Ogami, and Wada also worked together as did Zealous, Fubaka, and Yamada.
We looked around the school zone, thinking there might be some way to communicate with the outside. We didn't find anything. Sorry.
After that, we went back to the entrance hall. We waited to see if there was any way past that metal door.
Me and Ugami together couldn't make a goddamn dent. We threw desks and chairs, but nothing. It's tough, man, like iron.
That would be because it is iron.
And it is like we were busting that thing down head on.
I feel like I'm crying.
I will continue the report. That has nothing to do with contacting the outside at defensive slide entrance. There are staircases leading up and down, and both the dorms are in the school zone.
But there are shutters in the way, so we can't go up. The switch aren't ready either.
At this point in time, it appears as though we are only permitted to explore the building's first floor.
Solid.
Regardless, there remains the possibility of further floors existing above the now an accessible second. And thus the possibility of there being a way out. As it sounds,
to be quite honest, we didn't so much work together as we did nothing together. We were in the gymnasium the entire time. Scurrying around the building, searching for breadcrumbs just isn't me.
Huh?
What the hell were you guys thinking? Like, seriously, like, you did nothing? Nobody's about to invite me. Nobody came up to me and said, let's go. It's not right, making a pariah out of me. You can't do that. What's your problem? If you wanted to come along, you should have, like, said something. I take that back. Who would want to be around such a dirty whore? Dirty whore? Women like you with their empty heads and cheap bodies make me practically ill. It surprises me. You know, it blows my mind that you could just talk so much crap about someone you just met.
Mama!
Let's talk this out peacefully, dude. Getting so worked up is bad for your skin, okay?
He's right. Are you guys really such good friends you can fight like that?
I don't think that's what this is.
We heard what everyone has to say. You don't understand good for you as me. I was sitting in the cafeteria. There's a kitchen in the back of the refrigerator there is packed full of food. I don't see we'll have to worry about going hungry at least. As bountiful as supply may be, it will only last but a few days or 15 minutes. You can just eat seeds. B.I. bird folk! There's no need to worry. The fridge automatically stocks every day. Or so Monokuma says. You saw him? He appeared while I was inspecting the fridge, said that, and then ran off again. It happened too fast for me to believe that he's really radio-controlled. I'll tell him putting up a nice ninja teddy bear. I'm supposed to be serious, scary, or silly. You're alright though, right? He like try to eat you or anything? Eat? Hey, what do you mean by that? What do you mean, do you try to eat her? Cut it out!
Watch it, Larder! You're creeping way too hard! What are you, drinking sleazebag or something? Is anyone not a sleazebag when they're drunk, dude?
Hey there, quit screwing around, you guys! Are you paying attention? We've been in prison, we could be killed at any time!
This chick's right, this isn't time to be fucking around, we just gotta do something! Next thing we knew, a voice rose up above the crowd, cutting him off mid-sentence. Yeah, Sayaka, you're enjoying yourself.
You saw you're enjoying yourself? Are you just that confident? Are you yet to accept the truth of a situation?
What took you so long, Kirigiri? We already begun our assembly!
She responded by worse tossing a single sheet of paper onto the table. Huh? What's that?
A map of Kibigani Academy.
A map?
Wait, where did you get this?
So? Does it really matter?
Of course it does! A response like that only makes me all the more curious!
More importantly, like, what's that give us? Based on this, it appears the building where it is the exact same design as Kibigani Academy.
So this is actually the real Kibigani Academy? A structure area, at least. But a number of unusual modifications appear to have taken place.
Modifications?
I was only getting my hands on a map of the first floor, so I don't know the details.
So it's really is Kibigani Academy? And we weren't taken to girls?
Bullshit! You're saying the second... This is a school that fosters elites for the country's future?
But guys, this really is Kibigani Academy. Why are there any other students here?
Oh, come on, dude. Enough all the grim, dark talk. You're not concerned, Hakagure, about all this?
Concerned? What should we be concerned about, dude?
This shit's more scare tactics put on by the guys upstairs, right? If you're always letting that stuff like that get to you, you start puting ectoplasm, dude. Truth is truth. Good things come to those who wait, so it isn't the wait for the show to end.
What are you laughing about? I'm just hoping there'll be some good team while splitting up and investigating the building. Are you even listening? Everyone here says Katsura's investigation. Nobody found the way out. Nobody knows who did this to us. I know investigations will tell us that. It tells us that the unimpeachable truth is what we are trapped in a sealed building with no means of escape.
We could do nothing but send sounds at her words. Reality is what's staring us in the eyes. We kept trying to...
Don't remind me. What are you supposed to do? We're trapped here with no way out.
Simple. If you want to leave, kill someone.
Don't even joke about that. Guys, take it easy, please. If anyone we're going to do, we need to be calm about it.
Anyone got any bright ideas?
Adapt. Simply adapt to life here. It was just those hopes that we're stuck here. The inability to adapt is the inability to survive. It's not that strong or the clever who survive. It's those who are capable of change. I'm with that out on the table. I have a proposal for everyone.
Proposal?
We're trapped here, which means we must not only spend our days, but also our nights. I'm sure everyone remembers the rules concerning nighttime, yes?
10 p.m. to 7 a.m. is designated nighttime. Beware, certain areas are off limits during this time. Sleep permitted in dorm rooms. Deliberate use of any other room will be treated as sleeping in class.
I suppose we impose another nighttime rule.
Another rule?
You're forbidden from leaving your room during the nighttime. The school rules themselves are not enforced to curfew, but do we be prudent? And why is that? In our current situation, we are destined to spend our nights here cowering in fear. Never dispel the thought that someone would be coming to kill you. What? We'll always wait here, jumping at every bump in the night.
And this curfew will prevent that from happening?
Unlike the regular school rules, that is not enforceable. It will require everyone's cooperation. So, I think I'm in. Like the Gotchik said, if we establish our own rules, we're going to reach each other down.
As a boys' representative, I have no objections.
Aww. Who put you in charge?
Everyone's in favor then? Wonderful. In that case, I shall make my departure. Where are you going? It'll soon be nighttime. Then I'm going to take a shower before then. Pleasant dreams.
Vanilla went to her gate. Celeste left the cafeteria. So nausea was her motion that no one even thought to step in and stop her. She's impressively calm and businesslike. Not a qualm about sleeping in a place like this. Adaptability.
What now, Chairman? One person already bailed on us.
Yes. Very well. This should suffice for today's assembly. Nighttime is nigh upon us. We should best prepare ourselves for another day.
Do we really have to sleep here? What other choice do we have? We'll just, like, wear ourselves out if we don't sleep.
The only thing we can do today is call it quits.
Maybe through one day, but tomorrow.
Our only option is to continue what we started today. Should a discovery be made, we can reconvene.
Yeah, that sounds good. Let's call it night. I'm pretty tired, too.
I'm gonna begin the slow twist with the first night of the new academy walls.
Mangi, we better get going, too.
Yeah. Am I really gonna sleep in this room? Oh yeah, before I go to bed, I need to check the shower again. One of the girls' room is supposed to have locks, right? Alright, let's open her up. Oh god, I guess it really is.
It's not locked.
Ah! You're overreacting. It's like you've seen somebody's ghost. In this situation, one's saying it's more like you've seen some bear's ghost be more accurate.
What do you want?
Makoto Nagi! It's an abomination! Abomination! Conflagration! Obliteration! Actually, as it turns out, the door to your shower is just misaligned.
So the door won't open, not because it's locked, but because it's not aligned, right?
Do you not read my informational message? Do you not know how to read? Boys don't get locked for their showers. Besides, even if you had a lock, it wouldn't do you any good. That might do you some good, but I don't like to speed on that kind of stuff. Anyway, the secret opening that misaligned door of yours, I came here to tell you that. You ready? Pull up the,
pull up on the knob as you twist, then try to open the door. Give her a go.
Open the knob as I twist. I think Satan was able to open and close my door without any trouble.
And open. Isn't that kind of funny? You got the only guy that was aligned properly. Alright, just update a stupid to my high school lecture. Now that's what I call irony. Alright, now I'm gonna leave all abrupt like. This big bear got some things I need doing.
Hey, hold on! Dang it.
May I have your attention, please? The time is now 10 p.m. Nighttime is now in effect. The cafeteria is now off limits and doors will be, and the door will be locked momentarily. And with that, I wish you all a good night. Sweet dreams!
It's nighttime now. We all promised we would leave our rooms. Which is all I got left to do today is wind down and get some sleep. I'm wondering myself, I collapse into my bed and close my eyes. I've been so much sleepy, I was extraordinarily worn out. I wonder how I could be made to watch movies nonstop all day long. Fooling my mind to believe I've been thrown into a world of fiction. That's perfectly natural. No one could just up and accept that they've been thrown into a situation like this. And that's the current fall of my first day at Kibigani Academy. If I fall asleep here, I'm not gonna wake up and find out it was all a dream, am I? As a plot twist, that's pretty terrible. Wouldn't it be amazing? That'd be the best possible end. Monokuma Theater, Act 1.
Mr. Monokuma, finisher's preparations looking rather pleasant. When I think of the days to come, the days we are starting here today, I am filled with pride and joy. For bringing such a wonderful ceremony for us, for the new students, I give my deepest gratitude. I am a standing oath of honor, students at Kibigani Academy. Aim to achieve individual
I'll unread.
Good morning, you guys! It's now 7 a.m. Rise and shine! Let's make today the best day it can be!
It sounds like it's morning. Without windows, I can't be sure. Anyway, what should I do today? Well, for the time being, I'll find Maizono and see if she has any ideas. She'll tell me she'd be my sidekick. Alright, to Maizono's room I go. Oh boy. Having adequately fired myself up, I step out of the room. Okay, I guess I put the intercom button. I guess I just push the intercom button to the door, huh?
Yes?
Good morning, Maizono.
Nagi, perfect timing.
Perfect timing?
Nagi, I have a favor I'd like to ask of you.
A favor?
I was in my heading out. I was wondering if maybe you would join me.
I don't mind.
Well, I can just defend myself.
Defend?
There are traps in there. In here. You don't know. They're trying to come after us.
Whoever trapped us in here, whoever created that wolf for murder, who took that rational scenario, could indeed come after us at any moment.
That's why no matter what happens, I want to be able to protect myself.
And so she wants to find a weapon she keeps herself in. And that case, I guess that's what she could use in the display case outside the gym.
Outside the gym? Right, let's go.
Again?
Of course. I'm an Esper. Just kidding. I'm kidding. That's my feeling, that's all.
My thoughts pattern really that simplistic. I should have that before you outside the gym with Maizono. Let me find when dealing with trying to give the dragon a hand to me, and possibly a cat from a lord to teleport from the map station to the electrode ID. It's really rather simple. Open the map menu and select your destination. You will want to teleport to a specific land which is designated on your map. You cannot teleport to a floor that is sealed or one you have not previously visited. Furthermore, it will be a situation that is dictated by the story, which you are unable to teleport. To prevent you from teleporting, the wall is becoming lost forever. Please understand. I encourage you to experiment with your newfound ability. Over and out. Okay, well, let me see. I guess it was the map. I
kitchen.
Ow.
Here we go, the gymnasium. I guess we just head right over there. Ah, I think that's sort of what Nagy had in mind. Is that a sword? It actually looks like it's just a practice sword. Even though the sword's got quite the unique taste, the attack's been glitted to up to hilt. On top of that, yeah, I saw it. It was touching my hands, covered in gold leaf.
You're right. It's in your hand.
It might be good for
your self-defense, but still.
Alright, I thought it would be better than nothing.
Watch me back with you, Nagy. I like some quirky interior design.
Interior design?
But you want to be careful bringing it back. You're up to the newspaper.
Interior design, I'm taking it with me.
If there's anything else you're going to use for self-defense.
But hey, there's no need to worry. It's not going to get something anytime soon. Anyway, if it comes to that, then I'll protect you.
You'll protect me, Nagy? Thank you. To my side, Nagy. I don't need a weapon.
God, Maizono is just so adorable. Maizono laughed as she said that. I've seen your wondrous smile. A smile that's at my heart at ease. Seeing that smile, it makes me think I could really do anything.
I look up on the weapon search and says, here, how about we talk a bit?
Okay, sure. What'd you have in mind, Maizono?
I was thinking we should talk about something. I'm not sure what to talk about. I'm sorry, that was my idea.
It's okay, you're fine. Silence is fine too if we don't talk about it, isn't it? Just being here together and trying to force conversation. Nice?
Just being here?
But I guess that's boring, isn't it, Maizono? Not doing anything, just being here.
No, it's not boring. I'm not used to it, just being somewhere.
Like playing on high school soon like me. You're busy every day, Maizono.
Sorry, it's kind of abrupt. Do you have a dream idea?
If I did, would you tell me yours? I want to know what your dream is too, Maizono.
My dream? As a little girl, I've always yearned for the stage. At home, which is my dad and I. Now I work late every night and I stay at home alone. I was just a child, so I was kind of lonely. Watching idols on TV and living their wonderful lives vicariously distracting me from my loneliness. They could sing, they could dance, and they were pretty like princesses. But above all, it was the way they smiled. Seeing their smiles, my loneliness would vanish in a puff of smoke. I would be like those idols one day and be able to warm its hearts. And that's what I thought.
That's amazing, Maizono. You've achieved your childhood dream. It really is amazing.
I did whatever I needed to fulfill my dream, including some bad things. I also did whatever it took.
Huh?
I believe you chase after your dream, yeah, because you can absolutely make it come true. But to do that, you must always be dreaming. And if it's a bad dream, whether you're awake or you're asleep, to make your dream come true, you must always be dreaming. In their world, if you falter even just a little, you'll be left behind. You have to swim with all your might, no chance to catch your breath. It really is that kind of world.
That sounds tough. Then you don't enjoy it?
No, it's not at all. I enjoy it a lot. That's why I'm scared.
What?
Right now, every day is amazingly fun. Everyone in my group is just wonderful to work with. We're all close friends, good rivals. And we're precious friends. We've always been together. If I didn't have them, I'd probably already given up on my dream. We followed our dreams together. We found work together. I truly am happy now. That's why I get scared sometimes. What happened when the world gets tired of us? I lose my dream, my seat in paradise. We'll all go our separate ways.
Maizono, is she shaking? She's scared. She's afraid of losing the ultimate dream she's worked so hard to attain.
That's how the reason I decided to roll in Kibigani Academy.
What? What do you mean?
Because you graduate from here, you're guaranteed success in life, right? If I could just do that, I could see you with my precious friends forever. That's what I thought. But instead, I'm trapped in this place and I can't get out. My friends, they're waiting. I'm sure they're waiting. Well, they're freaking out of me. Well, congratulations, sister. And despite that...
Maizono?
I don't have time for this.
First time I heard Maizono shouting, expressing her emotions. Anger. But she's probably right to be angry. After all, the dream she had fought to take hold of was slipping away because she was trapped here. No fought doesn't do her justice. There's no way I can know just how hard it was.
I'm sorry for complaining to you about something you can't do anything about. Is this uncomfortable for you?
No, not at all.
I'm sorry.
Hey, Maizono? Are you hungry by any chance? Come back to our room, so I have to get something to eat with me in the cafeteria?
In that case, why don't I make something? But you know, I guess I'm a good cook.
Oh, really? What's your specialty?
Chili oil.
A condiment?
I'm kidding.
Maizono laughed. The eruption of emotion disappeared from her face and she was back to her usual cheerful self. I wonder why. Her expression was like a master woman going out in public. After that, Maizono and I ate in the cafeteria and returned to our rooms. A gilded practice sword for a plain room. It's nothing if not out of place. Anyway, there's still some time left in the day. I don't feel like hanging out here, so I should go find somewhere else to go. Free time is about to begin. Why not? You can stay at Kibigane Academy, but occasionally have something called free time. During free time, you're able to enhance your intimacy with other students. Afterwards, you can give them a present and try to snatch another affection points. Friends can be bought from the Monomono machine in the school shop. Please do drop by as you go more into your partners or unlock secret bonding events. Some information will be added to your report cards. At that time, your partner might also teach your new school, which will come in handy. Keeping your interest in with as many students as possible. By the hand of another student, call us time to pass and return to your bedroom. That's what I do two times. Free time one. Oh, so it's kind of like social linking at Persona 4. Because, like, if you guys haven't played Persona 3 or Persona 4, when you do a social link, you gradually pass time with someone, your bonds grow closer with them. And, like... Sayaka Maizono? Of course! I know Jax is taking her as your first point. Free time. Let's check the maps here. Let's see if Maizono's in a room or something.
I'm scared. This place terrifies me.
Should I have Maizono do something? Yeah, let's go hang out with Maizono.
Are you trying to cheer me up? I'm sorry for taking so much of your time.
I didn't really care to come for Maizono. Maizono and I bonded a little. I guess I'll just give her the school insignia pin. Here it is. Sorry, no, I can't do a key on something. Shit! No, I'm okay. I'm supposed to give mine.
Maybe we talk over a little?
Sure, what's wrong? Why are you being serious all of a sudden?
Because I'm seriously leaning on you right now, Nayaki.
Huh?
Just being with you, I've still felt afraid, less uncertain. Hard all this would be for me if you weren't here. Of course, it's still terrifying having you here by my side is my comfort.
Maizono. Those words coming from her mouth, coming from Sayaka Maizono's mouth. I was ecstatic, but probably tomato red. I feel the same way, Maizono. Being here has really helped me get through things, too.
Really? Do you mean it? I'm flattered.
Maizono's smiling face is a serious way to put my heart at ease. Exaggerating, her smile really was carrying me through all this.
It's kind of funny, isn't it? I know I'd be able to talk like this, like real friends. Wear a mask, you might talk to me.
It's for no serious normal person, and you're a celebrity. Wait, how'd you know that? How did I want to make eye contact with you?
Because I was always sneaking glances at you.
You were?
I was always on the lookout for a chance to talk to you.
Talk to me?
I can never get a moment to myself. came before I found a chance. I still regret it.
But why me of all people?
Do you remember back in 7th grade when the huge bird got lost in the school pond?
I think I remember something like that, yeah.
This bird shows up a lot in Japanese legends. It lived for 1,000 years. The tortoise, 10,000.
The bird thing I lost and lost in the pond in 7th grade. I'm pretty sure it was,
Oh, shit. I'll be right back. I'm sorry, guys. I had to do that. So I'm pretty sure it was a crane.
It was a crane, right?
It was crane, so I wasn't helping you see a real crane. Something and she wasn't sure what to do about it. She went to the forest back to school where I could get away.
Well, I got roped into it because it happened to be the day to take care of class's pets.
I'll do this.
Should I express my gratitude for what you did back then?
Your gratitude?
I am that queen. I couldn't repay my debt. Allow me to weave a cloth for you. Just kidding.
Yes, I know.
I really was below you, didn't I, Iggy? Should I want a chance to talk to you? If only just once. Although I never would have guessed my wish for you. It's quite like this.
I should have some dramatic room in a town or something. That's like what happened, and it happened here in this creepy place.
I have been thinking that if that cream could come here as a tune, I hate
it. Guys, I gotta stop doing the voice for Maizono. I'll just like read along, you guys can read along with me for now. Again, we're being an ass. Sayaka Maizono's report card has been updated. Gradually, quiet at school, voice of gold. After parting with Maizono, I turned my room for a little bit. Shit, it's nighttime. I can't do the voice for any of the characters for a while, because I gave all of it to Maizono, so, I guess we're just gonna read for a while. His Japanese voice is so adorable, I just want to give him a hug. Okay guys, I'm gonna stop this off right here and I'll continue. And I will continue, later. Oops. Which one was it? Ah, here it is. Save right here. And then I will continue, in another gameplay. So far, we've been introduced to the school, we've explored it a bit, we found a nice gilded sword, and we hung out with Maizono. I see that accomplishes it for now. If you guys are liking this gameplay, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, comment, and I guess we're going to continue on a bit more Danganronpa in a bit. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.